to examine solid-state battery patent applications submitted to the World Intellectual Property Organization and other organizations, Nikkei collaborated with the Tokyo research company Patent Result. The study examined applications submitted from 10 nations and territories between 2000 and the end of March. With 1,331 recognized patents, the study discovered that Toyota Motor is by far the largest holder of solid-state battery patents. With 445 patents, Panasonic Holdings is a distant second. Idemitsu Kosan is the owner of 272 patents. Only one non-Japanese company, Samsung Electronics, entered the top five, coming in fourth. Overall, six of the top 10 positions were held by Japanese businesses. And just recently, the Toyota research team leaked a semi-solid-state battery that might hit the market first, considering Toyota is struggling to mass-produce its solid-state battery. And so in today's episode, let's find the pros and cons of semi-solid batteries compared to solid-state batteries. According to the report, Toyota, which has been working on solid-state batteries since the 1990s, has patents covering a wide range of topics, including battery structure, materials, and production procedures. Toyota has had difficulty scaling up the production of solid-state batteries, but newly developed semi-solid technology may provide an option. Is the energy transition's next big thing truly solid-state batteries? The potential is obvious as a technology that can extend the range of electric vehicles, enable fast charging, and improve safety. However, despite solid-state technology's long history of promise and lack of concrete evidence of its effectiveness, semi-solid batteries, a novel hybrid technology, may render solid-state obsolete even before it has a chance to take off. But what distinguishes semi-solid from solid-state? For solid-state batteries, scale is a major problem. Scale is the main barrier preventing the transition of solid-state manufacturing from the pilot plant to the gigafactory. The basic enabling element is the solid electrolyte, which swaps out the liquid electrolyte found in today's conventional lithium-ion batteries, LIB. To improve performance and encourage longer cycle life, the solid electrolyte must nevertheless accomplish what is simple for liquids: enter all open places in a cell. The electrolyte volume in one EV is comparable to the size of three tennis courts. Therefore, without utilizing extremely accurate and time-consuming manufacturing procedures, it is almost impossible to create a solid electrolyte that maintains as high of a contact area with electrodes as a liquid can. In the semiconductor industry, whereby batteries are built in vacuum and on an atom-by-atom scale, solid-state batteries have not succeeded in growing larger than the size of a fingernail. A high-scale production method is required if next-generation technology is to satisfy consumer demand for better and safer EVs. Technology for semi-solid batteries offers a middle ground. Some have embraced a compromise technology, semi-solid, even though solid-state developers have been battling this problem since the turn of the century or longer. Low contact surfaces and sluggish production processes can be solved by mixing both solid and liquid electrolyte components. However, semi-solid isn't a golden goose. Although still an improvement over existing cells, the liquid electrolyte increases the weight and volume of the cell, which limits the increase in cell energy and, thus, EV range. And let's get into more details. What's a semi-solid state battery? A battery is referred to as a semi-solid battery if one electrode does not contain a liquid electrolyte and the other electrode does. Or, half of the total mass or volume of the electrolyte in the monomer is made up of the solid electrolyte. Semi-solid batteries are smaller, more reliable, and safer than current lithium-ion batteries. They also have a higher energy density and are significantly less expensive than lithium-ion batteries. Significant battery businesses are currently choosing to accelerate the research and development of semi-solid batteries, first due to the fact that solid-state batteries still have significant issues with scalability, commercialization, and pricing. The basic principles of semi-solid batteries. The battery uses two streams of the slurry, one positively charged and the other negatively charged, as the electrodes. The electrodes are made of tiny particles of the lithium compound combined with a liquid electrolyte. A water-permeable membrane separates the two slurry beams as they pass through aluminum and copper current collectors. Lithium ions are exchanged when the two beams of slurry move through the membrane, resulting in current flow on the outside. The battery may be recharged by simply applying a voltage that causes the ions to move away from the membrane. The primary benefits of a semi-solid battery: high energy density. Generally speaking, 300 watt-hour per kilogram to 400 watt-hour per kilogram is the upper limit of energy density for liquid lithium-ion batteries. Solid-state batteries have a theoretical energy density of up to 700 watt-hour per kilogram, which is about twice as much as the statistics for the most technologically advanced lithium batteries. Can be used at low temperatures. The solid electrolyte is utilized in semi-solid batteries, and the electrolyte in solid form has no effect on battery performance due to low temperature. This essentially resolves the issue of battery life reductions for pure electric vehicles throughout the cold. Higher security. There is little to no liquid in a solid-state or semi-solid battery, if any at all. As a result, spontaneous combustion or explosion will be successfully prevented in the event of damage or puncture. Longer service life. Currently, the semi-solid battery is cycled 2,000 times at room temperature, and the capacity retention rate is greater than 85%, according to the data that is accessible. The ordinary liquid battery undergoes 1,200 cycles under the same conditions, but only around 80% of its capacity is retained. Toyota researchers have put lithium titanate batteries and semi-solid batteries through safety testing to see how well they function in terms of safety. The researchers put the two batteries through acupuncture testing, extreme overcharge tests, short circuit tests, and extreme heating tests in accordance with the necessary criteria, and then evaluated the use of the two batteries in the EV industry based on the test findings. The two sets of test subjects only experienced a modest pressure decrease and a slight increase in body temperature during the acupuncture test. There were no other noticeable phenomena. The lithium titanate battery caught fire during the extreme overcharge test, and the lithium iron phosphate semi-solid battery deflated after swelling and being overcharged to 19 volts. The lithium iron phosphate semi-solid battery's overcharge duration is only 10 minutes, and when an overcharge fault happens, the SOC is 117%, according to the test curve. In contrast, the lithium titanate battery's overcharge duration is 48 minutes, and when an overcharge fault occurs, the SOC is 218%. Prior to the fire, the lithium titanate battery's rate of temperature rise was slower than that of the lithium iron phosphate semi-solid battery, and at the time of the fire, the temperature changed abruptly. Both batteries are capable of meeting the demands of pertinent standards, but the lithium titanate battery has a far higher overcharge capability, tolerance of overcharge time, than the lithium iron phosphate semi-solid battery. In the short circuit test, the two batteries' maximum short circuit current exceeds 800 amperes, and their combined maximum temperature increases around 100 K. While the lithium titanate battery has no evident phenomenon, the lithium iron phosphate semi-solid battery exhibits a clear swelling phenomenon. Both battery groups underwent abrupt temperature fluctuations below 200 degrees Celsius during the extreme heating test, and at the same time, the voltage quickly plummeted to 0 volt and there was heavy smoking. The two tested goods can withstand temperatures far higher than the standard's maximum temperature limit of 130 degrees Celsius, which has a high level of safety. The test results demonstrate the excellent level of safety for both the lithium titanate battery and the lithium iron phosphate semi-solid battery. Although the lithium iron phosphate semi-solid battery has a weak overcharge ability, it does not experience a fire phenomena after an overcharge and is thus safe. Lithium titanate batteries have a large overcharge capacity and can tolerate overcharge for a long period. Two major Chinese manufacturers, NIO and Dongfeng Motor, have placed their flags in the camp of the semi-solid. Using the technology provided by WeLion and Ganfeng Lithium, respectively, they each declared plans to produce electric vehicles. Even though the energy of the cell is lower than what pure solid state might provide, the compromise approach is a step forward and can be produced on a large scale, perhaps making solid state unnecessary. With that being said, what do you think of Toyota's semi-solid state battery? Could this be a match to Tesla's EV battery? Let us know your thoughts in the comment box below. And if you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.